Hey everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Today I am going to be talking through my November TBR. I cannot believe that it's time for a November TBR, especially since the December TBR seems to be very up in the air because of the holidays and everything that's going on. So I feel like November is the last time that I can get consistent reading in. Sometimes in December, I have tons of time to read and I feel like I do one of my best reading months of the year. And other times I'm just so busy that I don't get to read anything. So I feel like November is me grasping at the last vestiges of my stability. Like this is the last time that I'm able to feel like I am on top of things for 2021. But I am feeling good about this month's TBR. In October, I had in September as well. September and October were some very beefy TBR months. October in particular had a couple of very long books. And I feel like I have a little bit more flexibility with this TBR because even though there are 10 books on it, I think some of them I can get through quite quickly and some of them I may be able to swap out if I'm not really feeling them. So I have a little bit more flexibility in terms of integrating a little bit of mood reading. The first couple of books that I want to talk about are going to be some buddy reads because we actually did a buddy read for Empire of the Vampire on my Discord server in October, and it was really, really fun. Regardless of how people felt about the book, I think everyone had a really good time just reading it together and discussing the book. It is a very small Discord server, so there's just a handful of us, and at least for me, I know that jumping into kind of these fully loaded Discord servers can feel very intimidating. So I like having that smaller atmosphere, and if you are someone who has been otherwise a little bit nervous about coming into Discord, not really knowing how to break into a bigger group, then you by all means can come and join one of these buddy reads in November if it is a book that you are looking forward to. And so for the very first book of the month, I will talk about the first buddy read that we are doing. So this book is a book that I put on my science fiction TBR video months and months ago, and that is Children of Time by Adrian Tchaikovsky. I haven't read anything by Adrian Tchaikovsky, but I've heard so many good things, especially from Alan, who loved Guns of the Dawn and is now doing, I believe the series is called Shadow of the Apt, but is reading a bunch of Tchaikovsky's books and really enjoying them. There's a lot of love for Children of Time, and really the only thing that I know about it is that it is science fiction and that there are sentient spiders. I think the spiders are sentient. There's another race of spider-like creatures. So I'm looking forward to it. So many people have said that this is one of their favorite recent works of science fiction. There's a couple of people in the Discord right now who have already read it and said it's one of their favorite books of the year. So I am really, really excited to get to this. I am excited to be crossing so much sci-fi off my list. Actually, I've read a lot more sci-fi this year than I thought I was going to. And for big sci-fi fans, you're probably going to scoff at that because it's still probably only like 4 or 5 books. But I feel like that's really good for me. I usually read other genres in place of sci-fi. So I have read a lot of books that I really enjoyed this year. And I'm hoping that Children of Time will be another one that I totally fall in love with. We are going to start this read-along on the channel on the very first day of November, so in a couple of days' time. And if you haven't read it or you've been wanting to read it, then please stop by. We would love to have you and chat with you about that. But I'm really excited for Children of Time. The next buddy read, excuse me, the next buddy read is one that we've scheduled for the week after. I don't really know how quickly we're going to get through Children of Time. When we did Empire of the Vampire, it took about a week or so for us to get through it. And I feel like Children of Time is a little bit shorter than that book. So hopefully a week will be good. And on the second Monday of November, November 8th, I am going to be starting. I don't know why my voice is giving out today. It's early in the morning. I haven't had to talk a whole lot, so I have no idea, but I apologize. I'm going to be starting Mistborn for the third time. So I have tried to read this first book in the Mistborn trilogy, which I believe is called The Final Empire. I don't know why my copy just calls it Mistborn. I guess maybe that's something they did for marketing purposes, since people might think that The Final Empire is like a last book in a series. I'm not sure. If you're a big Mistborn fan and you know the answer to that question, then feel free to let me know. But I'm going to be restarting this for the third time. So I have picked up this first book a couple of times. And it's not that I've kind of gotten into it and not liked it. It's that the first couple of pages didn't pull me in the two times that I picked it up. And I was just not in the mood and I put it aside and didn't end up getting back to it. But there are a couple of people in the Discord server who have also really wanting to read Mistborn for a long time. And I feel like it is finally time to get into it. I am personally very interested in reading the Stormlight Archive, but I do want to read Mistborn first. I know a lot of people have told me that you don't have to. A lot of Brandon Sanderson fans have told me that you don't have to, but that's just the way that I would like to do it. So I have read Warbreaker, and now I'm going to read the Mistborn trilogy, and then we will see if I'm going to go on to the other Mistborn books or on to Stormlight from there. But I'd love to be able to at least get to the first, like, one or two Stormlight books next year. So I am looking forward to this Mistborn read. We are going to start it on the Discord server on November the 8th. So if you too have been wanting to read Mistborn, or if you want to reread or just chat about it, then you can feel free to jump in and do that. I have 4 buddy reads this month, which is a lot for me because I tend to swap books in and out of the TBR very randomly, very haphazardly. So this will force me to stick to certain books, and I am equally parts excited and nervous about that. But the third buddy read that I'm going to be doing is The Heroes by Joe Abercrombie. So this is the second standalone novel in Joe Abercrombie's kind of trilogy of standalones that follows the First Law trilogy. And this one, I have heard, has some excellent battle sequences. It seems to be somewhat polarizing. I've heard from some people it is the best of all the standalones. Some people really don't like it. I am looking forward to reading it. I have not disliked a book by Abercrombie yet, so I am looking forward to it. I'm actually contemplating listening to this one because I have heard a lot of great things about the audiobook narrator, and I always like to have an audiobook for the month that I can kind of make my way through a little bit slowly. So we will see. It always depends on how excited I am to get reading. Sometimes I start the audiobook and it's just too slow and I need to read a little more quickly, and so I bail out on the audiobook, and I don't want to do that if I'm using one of my credits for it. So I will think a little bit harder on whether or not I will use audio for this. But if you have any strong recommendations one way or the other for audio, specifically for The Heroes, because I know the narrator is great and I've heard a lot of wonderful things about his voice for Glockta and those types of things, but if you believe he does a good job with the standalones as well, then please let me know, because I need to decide how I'm going to consume this book. But looking forward to The Heroes. I don't think there's a set date for the buddy read for this one yet. So the plan right now is just to read it in November. And more details to follow, I guess. If you are interested in reading it, if you're making your way through the standalones and you want to have some friends to chat about it with, then just pop into the Discord and let us know. And the very last buddy read for the month is not a Discord buddy read. This is a buddy read, and I think it's going to end up being more of a book discussion. I don't know how much we're going to be reading at the same time. I think everybody's just going to be reading this in November so that we can discuss it afterward. But that is Daniel Abraham's Long Price Quartet Book 1, which I believe is called Shadow in Summer. Yes, A Shadow in Summer. This is the bind-up, so it's called Shadow and Betrayal because it has the first 2 books in it. But I have wanted to read these books ever since I heard Alan over at the Library of Alexandria talk about them. I'm sure many of us on BookTube have had a similar experience where we have heard Alan say such wonderful, glowing things about the Long Price Quartet. And the way that he describes it just makes it seem like something that I would really love. He describes it as a more introspective, character-driven, slow-paced novel that kind of, or I guess quartet that kind of builds over time and really lets you get to know the characters and come to appreciate them and how they grow and how they change, which I am very much looking forward to. I have never read anything by Daniel Abraham, so I'm hoping that his writing style will click with me, because that can be, for me, with books that are a little bit slower paced, books that require you to take your time to do a lot of reflection, To me, I tend to notice the quality of the prose in those books a lot more than your kind of fast, action-packed, plot-driven books. I can kind of ignore the prose in those books because you're just flipping by so quickly and there's a lot of stuff that's happening on every page. And so the prose kind of takes a back seat. But when there are these more meditative works, works that challenge you or kind of push you to reflect on what's happening, I feel like the prose means a lot more to me. So hopefully his will be a style that I connect with. I really, really want to love these books. I think these might be the books of the entire year of reading. These are the books that I want to love the most because the way that Alan has sold them has just made me feel like they're something that I should fall in love with. And I really want to. And I think I will be disappointed if I do not. And also, Alan has not forgiven me for both reading and then enjoying Empire of the Vampire. And I feel like if I want to win his friendship back, then I need to like Long Price Quartet. So I have a lot invested in this novel reading experience. But I'll be reading it with a bunch of other booktubers with the goal of doing some discussions about the books. And hopefully that will be enjoyable for everyone involved. Moving on from there are just the books that I would like to read this month. These ones are not buddy reads, but by all means, I always love talking about what I'm reading. So if you want to discuss any of these, then I am happy to do so. The next three are the Thrawn trilogy. I need to slow down so that I can pronounce words properly. These books were on my 21 books that I wanted to read in 2021 list. They were also on my science fiction list that I did a couple of months ago. I have been wanting to dip into the expanded universe, the Star Wars expanded universe. I think I've talked about this before in my bookshelf tour, but my husband is a diehard Star Wars fan. I really like Star Wars, but to compare how much I like Star Wars to how much he likes Star Wars, I feel like they're not even in the same universe. So I would like to be able to read some of the EU so that I can chat with him about it. And his recommendation was to start with the Thrawn trilogy, just because I only need the knowledge of the original three movies in order to move on from there, and because they're really enjoyable, apparently. So I believe that these will be quick reads. These are super old, like yellowed copies, but I think they're going to be quick reads. I hope I'm going to enjoy them and that they're going to be easy to flick through. So I would really love to get to the full trilogy this month, but I will at least make sure to read the first book. But I'm really looking forward to that. I haven't read any Star Wars books before. I'm trying to think about it. I think I may have read aloud a Star Wars. I started to read a Star Wars book to my son about Obi-Wan Kenobi because he loves Obi-Wan. But I think at the time that I had tried to read it, the chapters were a little bit too long for him and we paused. But that's my only experience with anything Star Wars related in novelization form. So really looking forward to that and hopefully I will enjoy it. And then I'll have to go to my husband for some advice about where to go next in the EU. This next book is one that I am actually bringing over from my October TBR, which I don't do often because there are lots of times I would say I read about 50% of the books that I put on my TBR because my mood changes or I just don't feel like picking something up and I don't want to force myself to read something. That does and has happened, but I do not enjoy it. If I can at all avoid it, I do not want to do it. However, one of my goals has been to read the first three Wheel of Time books before the television show is released, which is now going to be the month that this book TBR is for. But I do not think I'm going to meet that goal. I don't think I'm going to make it through three books because I have to carry over book two, The Great Hunt, onto my November TBR. I am still going to aim to have books one and two done before I start the TV show, but that may not be possible. I wish that the Wheel of Time was coming more naturally to me. I wish that it was a story that I felt like I could totally get sucked into and that pulled me along at a fast clip and that I could kind of breeze through those books, but I do struggle with the writing style. That is not to say that I think that the writing style is bad. I just think that it is not the type of writing that I enjoy, and it makes me feel bogged down. And then once I feel bogged down, I feel like I'm totally displaced from the story. I know that I am reading something. I'm not immersed in it. I'm not experiencing it in the way that I want to. And that has been really challenging. But I am going to persevere with book two. I am hoping to enjoy reading book two more than I enjoyed reading book one. And I have transferred it over to this TBR with the intention of at least getting through those first two novels before I check out the first couple episodes of the TV show. The last book that I have to read in physical copy is H is for Hawk, which if you've been following the channel for a long time, because this is one of my earliest videos, I believe, I put this on a 5-star predictions video. This is a memoir written by Helen McDonald that has, I think, a couple of different narrative threads. So it talks about her experiences training a hawk. It talks about her grief from the loss of one of her parents, and it talks about her reading a story by T.H. White, author of The Once and Future King, about his experiences training a hawk. So I think there's a couple of different narratives that kind of weave together there. This is highly acclaimed. It caused a huge amount of buzz when it was first released, and I have wanted to read it and have owned it for a really long time, and I am hoping that November is the month that I'm going to be able to get around to reading it. I have been doing very poorly with my nonfiction reading in the last quarter of the year. And I'm hoping that I can at least get through this one and maybe another before the end of the year. I think it will still work out to me having read 12 books for the year, which is my goal. I like to read at least one work of nonfiction per month, but some of them were definitely stacked in earlier months because there's been a few months now, unfortunately, where I haven't picked up anything that was nonfiction. So I'm hoping that I'm going to be able to get through this in November and that it will, in fact, as I predicted, be a 5-star read for me. So those are all of the physical books on my TBR. There is one book that I do not own that I will pick up on Kindle or potentially from the library if I am able. And that is one of the 2021 releases that I was looking forward to. And that's called A Marvelous Light. I will just pop a picture of it up on the screen. So this is a 2021 release that I think was when I was reading about it, because I didn't go back and review the synopsis again before this video, which maybe I should have. But I believe the way that it was pitched in the article that I had been reading was Jonathan Strange and Mr. Norrell meets, I think it was Red, White, and Royal Blue. I think this is a queer romance fantasy set in Victorian or Edwardian England, I think. The cover looks very beautiful. I remember when I read the synopsis the first time, I was really intrigued by it. It sounded like something that I would really enjoy. And I wanted to read it before the end of the year. It was one of the 2021 releases that I still had on my list to get through. So I'm going to attempt to read that one as well. And we will see how it goes. I'm looking forward to it. It'll be nice to get another new release on the list. And like I said, this feels a lot more manageable than some TBRs from months past, I think, because there's no really gigantic books on here. Still some pretty big ones, but not 1,200 pages as it was in October. But that being said, other than the buddy reads, I still can expect a little bit of flexibility within the TBR. And I'm excited. All of these books are ones that I have been really, really looking forward to reading. And I get the feeling that November is going to be a good reading month. I feel like November, as I said, is the calm before the storm that is December, where you have the holidays. And so many people in my personal life have birthdays in December. So December is just like a whirlwind of things. It is my brother-in-law's 30th birthday. We're going out of town for like a big party for that. There is getting ready for Christmas. It's my birthday, my husband's birthday, my mom's birthday. There's a million birthdays. There's a million things to celebrate. It is a very fun month, but a very busy month. So I don't know how reading will go. So November feels like kind of the last hurrah for the reading year for me. Like I said, if anybody would like to join any of these buddy reads, we would love to have you. I would love to chat with you. Please let me know what you are reading in November, and I will see you with another video soon. Bye!